everybody. Today is Monday, the 18th of August, 2014, and it's time to return to the world of GeoGuessing. Thank you, everybody, who's been patient with me as I've taken a couple weeks off from GeoGuessr because mainly the site was being incredibly buggy, and I got busy with other things. I did have a lot of people disappointed that they weren't seeing it every day, so the website was so buggy that it almost was unplayable at times. But I've been told that it's gotten a lot better. I hope that is the case. Good luck, have fun. Of course, today's going to be a standard round of 5 rounds, 1 minute each. We are off and running. And we are underwater. Fantastic. So this is a good way to mark the return of GeoGuessr when we're underwater. Okay. I gotta be honest, in all my years of playing GeoGuessr, I've never seen us be underwater, but there's a stingray. let's see if we can name the fish. It's a sergeant major. That is looks like a wrasse. It's another sergeant major. Some bait fish here. Actually, they're a little bit too small to be bait fish. I couldn't tell what kind of stingray that was. Oh, these are little parrotfish, looks like. So I have absolutely no idea where we are. I'm just going to say Florida because we're underwater. And no, of course it's Australia. It's good. Thank you, Australia. We were only 14,702 kilometers away, and that was off the island of whatever of the Northwest Island Reef in the northeastern part of Australia. Good. Good. So yeah, that's a good one. Anyone who scores better than that, I'm going to assume that you probably looked at the round first, went back and played again, because how that could have been literally any water that had fish in it. All right. So is the attack of the, and by the way, yeah, the website's playing so much better now. So we're just walking down a trail here. It's very bright. And the standard definition monster has reared its ugly head again. By the way, congratulations to those of you who are going back to school this week. I do know that classes do resume, and hopefully you all, if you are watching this in the classroom, hope you're enjoying it. Be nice to your teachers, kids. Alright, so I have no idea where this is. I really don't. I'm just going to say Australia again. And it was Australia. Look at that. That was a literal complete guess. Just northwest of Melbourne, which, oh, I say just, but I mean, that could be the distance of about a couple thousand kilometers. That's alright. Actually, there's no way that could be a couple thousand kilometers. Well, a couple hundred. Hey, 2,100 points, I'll take it. Again, the standard par that you want to be getting yourself close to is about 10,000 for 10,000 for standard rounds is what this is. Whoa! What happened here? I think I like this camera better. Okay, so there's a map here. Connections south, road connections north. There's also signs everywhere, but none of them. Welcome to Nanutara. Where's Nanutara? Is that Australian? That sounds like an Australian name. I don't know why. It's Diesel. Okay, well, I'm just going to say Australia again because, Buzz Bomb, I guess. Yeah, it was Australia! I know my Australian names, I suppose. Nanutara is apparently right there. Nanutara Roadhouse. So, there you go. Hey! That's 3 for 3 on the Australian guesses. Well, I mean, that's 3 guesses that have been in Australia. It's not 3 for 3 that I've gotten right or close to. Alright, round 4. This is definitely not Australia. In fact, that does look Finnish? Swedish, possibly? Norwegian, maybe? It's one of those three. Look, Zinvik does a lot of things. One thing I'm not good at is geography. and the positive identification of Nordic languages. Okay, so I'm going to assume that this is either going to be, there's a sign. These are actually cities. I'm going to guess probably Sweden. It's green enough to where I want to say that it's not that far north. I'm going to say somewhere near the Norwegian border. That's what I'm going to say. Nope, it was actually Finland. So it may have been Swedish, but most likely it was Finnish. That was in. I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. I cannot. If I could fake accents, I would, but I just can't. Well, outside of the first guess, we're actually not doing too bad, given that the first guess was just awful. So we are at a spot that we can't currently move from, and this is certainly a volcano. Well, it might not be. I guess it could be just a crater, but this is volcanic soil right here. That's exactly what it looks like. It's very pretty up here. Very, very pretty. I bet that water is so cold. Well, I'm getting a not an Alaskan vibe, but kind of an Icelandic vibe, possibly. I mean, Iceland's a good guess because it's right in the middle of. It could be Canada, it could be Europe, or it could be Iceland. Or it could be Mexico, because Invicta is awful at everything. How is that Mexico? Parque Nacional Nevado de Toluca. According to Invicta, right in the heart near Mexico City of Mexico looks exactly like Iceland. So kids, don't ever come to Sinvicta for geography lessons. Listen to your teachers, they're gonna know better. So final total today is going to be 7,470 points. Again, the beginning guess was kind of cheap. The last guess was also a little bit cheap. It's always cheap whenever you get a spot that you can't move from. So final total is 7,470. I'll take it. I hope you are enjoying the start to your school year, for those of you who did start again. And yeah, expect to see the return of GeoGuessr here on my channel. Have a fantastic day, everyone. Until next time, so long, everybody.